अज्ञानति मिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। हरे कृष्णा, वेलकम टू आवर टुडेज टॉपिक पेनल कोड इन भगवद गीता। सो इन भगवद गीता 10th चैप्टर टेक्स्ट 38 द लॉर्ड सेज दंडो दमयतामस्मि। व्हाइल क्रिएटिंग दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड दंडो दमयतामस्मि मीन्स अमंग ऑल मीन्स ऑफ सप्रेसिंग लॉलेसनेस आई एम पनिशमेंट। सो दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड वॉज क्रिएटेड बाई द लॉर्ड। सो मेनी लिविंग एंटिटीज आर देयर, पर्टिकुलरली देर आर इट इज सेड दैट देर आर 84 lakhs काइंड ऑफ लिविंग एंटिटीज आर देयर। सो अमंग देम ह्यूमन बींग्स आर ऑफ 4 lakh काइंड्स। सो दिस पनिशमेंट अप्लाइज टू ह्यूमन बींग्स, ऑल अदर बीस्ट एंड बर्ड्स एट्सेट्रा ट्रीज दे आर नॉट सब्जेक्ट टू दिस पनिशमेंट। Human being, because he has got a special intelligence, so he can distinguish from vice and virtue, etc. So this applies to human beings only, punishment. So this material world was created by the Lord, and at the same time, this Veda was also created by the Lord. Veda comes from the breathing, from the nostril of the Lord. So then there are various rules and regulations, how to regulate your life, how to live according to that rules and regulations. So in Veda it is stated that there are Vedo pranito dharma adharmastad viparjaya. Veda, there are recommended activities and there are also prohibited activities. If you do that prohibited activities, you are subject to punishment. There are various dignitaries for this punishment, just like the Jamaraj. Jamaraj is the final authority, Jamaraj. Here in this material world, we see that somebody may be doing some offenses, some rules, they may not follow the rules, or they may contravene the rules, but somehow or other in the judiciary case they are saved, they are escaped. But the Lord's arrangement is such that no one can escape Jamaraj. At the end of the life it will be finalized how much sins you have done, how much virtues you have done. So before death, one is required to make some atonement for that vices. That is called prayaschita. In Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th and Chaitanya Charitamrita, also it is said, Jaiche teiche joi koi kare smarana, chari vidha tapatara kare sangharana. So these vices, these are sinful activities, there are 4 kinds. One is pataka, urupataka, mahapataka and atipataka. Accordingly, punishment is given. There are 28 hellish planets are there, described in 5th canto, 26th chapter. According to your sinful activities, you will be sent there and you will be punished there. So before death, if you do this punishment, if you do this prayaschita or atonement, then there is no necessity or no requirement of going to the hellish planets. And the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Mahaprabhu says, just somehow or other, if one, jaichates joi koi kare smarana, somehow or other, if somebody remembers the Lord, then all the reactions of the sinful activities are vanished, or you are free from all these reactions of these sinful activities. So this also is described in Srimad Bhagavatam 6th canto, 1st chapter, text 15. Kechit kevalaya bhaktya vasudeva parayana abhang dhunnati kasnena nihara viva bhaskara. Because in the Srimad Bhagavatam 5th canto, 26th chapter, so many hellish planets were described, and so many persons suffering from their hellish planets were described. So Parikit Maharaj was very much worried about them. How somebody can be free from this punishment? So he asks this question in Srimad Bhagavatam 6th canto, 1st chapter. And Sukadeva Goswami describes there are various atonements are there. Just like karma prayaschita, jnana prayaschita and bhakti prayaschita. So the bhakti prayaschita is the best prayaschita. In that it is said that kechit kevalaya bhaktya vasudeva parayana agam dhunnati karsnena niyahara vibhaskara. Just like very few people know this. Others they do karma prayaschita. Most of them do not know what is prayaschita, what is atonement. They die simply just like animals, even getting human form of life. And finally they are tried there, or they are given punishment there by Jamaraj. But those who study the Vedic literature, Vedic scriptures, they know that atonement is required. That's why they do such atonements. And that there are three types of atonements. One is karma prayaschita, second is jnana prayaschita, and third is bhakti prayaschita. And karma and jnana prayaschita, they are not free. They cannot free one from the sinful activities, reactions of the sinful activities. But bhakti prayaschita is completely one will be free from sinful activities, reactions. And that is niharam eva bhaskara. Just like when in the autumn season, etc., there is a fog, and if sunrise is there, then that fog vanishes. Similarly, when one attends this bhakti, when one performs devotional service to the Lord, his all the sinful reactions of all sinful activities are vanished. In the Prabhupada Maharaj says, in this regard, Srila Jiva Goswami comments, the bhakti means divided into two divisions. One is santata, devotional service that continues incessantly with faith and love. And another is kadachit ki, devotional service that doesn't continue incessantly but is sometimes awakened. The two types of bhakti are there. And among, also incessantly followed devotional service, santata, we further divided into two. And this kadachit ki is further divided into three. So the point is that one who has caught even a slight glimpse of devotional service, all needs to undergo prayaschita, atonement are superseded. So there is also example that there, the evidence is there. Evidence is Ajamila, 6th canto, 2nd chapter. This Ajamila point has been given. By Sukadeva Goswami, because Parikit Maharaj, when he heard Shakron Manan Krishna Padara Vindayo Niveshita Tad Guna Ragi Jai Riha Nate Jamapasa Bruttyasa Tad Bhattan Sapne Vipassanti Chiran Niskruta Shakron Manan Krishna Padara Vindayo. Once even one you can utter the name of the Lord Krishna, then all atonements are no more required. He is completely atonement is done by this. So prayaschita, this Parikit Maharaj was astonished. How is it possible by simply uttering a name of the Lord Krishna, he will be free from all sinful activities, reactions of sinful activities. So Parikit Maharaj gave the example of Ajamila. He was doing so many sinful activities, and Jamaraj has prepared so much list for him. But at the time of death, he was 88 years old, and his 10th son was playing nearby. He is 5 years old. And at that time, 3 messengers of Jamaraj came, and seeing them, Ajamila was very much afraid. And he asked his son's name, by good fortune, his son's name was given Narayana. So he asked, Narayana Aya. And by that utterance of the name of the Lord, He was free from all reactions of sinful activities, and immediately four messengers of Lord Vishnu came and prevented those messengers of Jamaraj from taking Ajamila into the hellish planet. So this has been described in Srimad Bhagavatam 6th canto elaborately. Okay, thank you very much. Hare Krishna.